Welcome to the Amphenol Broadband Training video presented by Extreme Broadband Engineering. This product installation training is on the DL Series Data Plus amplifiers. In this training, we'll show what's included in the DL Data Plus amplifier package, explain the features of the DL Series Data Plus amplifiers, look at DC powering options, and show the mounting options. Let's look at what's included in the DL Series Data Plus amplifier package. The DL Data Plus amplifier, optional mounting screws if not using quick mounting, power inserter module, installation instructions for quick reference during installation, two service loss tags, and an AC-DC power pack. Next, I'll explain how to interpret the model number. The IPA stands for Infinity Premise Amplifier Line. The next spot can be a 1 or 2. The 1 indicates our traditional CATV series amplifiers, and the 2 indicates that it's enhanced to work in a MOCN environment. The next 2 spots indicates the forward gain of the amplifier from the input to any of the amplified RF output ports. The next location indicates how many active RF outputs the amplifier has. This can be 1, 4, or 8 outputs. If the next location has a D, it indicates it has a dedicated passive data port. If the next spot has an L, it indicates that it has a dedicated local power port. If there's an R in the next spot, it indicates it has an active return amplifier. If there's no R, it has passive return. If there is an R, the next spot indicates the gain of the return amplifier. If it's an S, it indicates that the gain is the same as in the forward direction. If it's not the same as the forward, the gain will be indicated by a number which represents the gain in dB. The last 2 spots indicate the housing style. VF indicates it's in a vertical true flex housing. Let's take a look at the port layout for the IPA-1008DL-RSVF Data Plus amplifier. The D stands for data port and the L for local powering. We call these amplifiers our DL series. As with all of our Data Plus amplifiers and splitters, the input port is located in the top left and is identified with a white port color. And the passive VoIP port is located in the lower left. The passive port is identified with a blue port color and blue label, making the installation easy and standardized. EMTAs and modems will be connected to this port. Since it is a passive port, it would not lose service if there was a power interruption to the amplifier. There's a dedicated local powering port, identified with a red port color, a LED power indicator, which is a visible indicator that the unit has DC power. There are 8 amplified forward and return unit gain ports, identified with yellow port colors. The IPA-1008DL-VF has 8 passive return ports. Each amplifier has a unique bonding block system, and 2 quick mount tabs for quick installation and servicing. The IPA-1004DL-RSVF has the identical layout as the 8-port amplifier. The only difference is it has 4 forward and return gain ports. The IPA-1004DL-VF has passive return. The DL series amplifiers comes with a side label for easy port identification when mounted horizontally, and a second green LED power indicator, which is a visible indicator that the unit has DC power. The DL series amplifiers integrate 3 devices into 1 compact housing. By eliminating 3 separate devices, it reduces jumpers needed and makes for a cleaner installation with less potential failure points. In this example, we're looking at the IPA-1008DL-RSVF. The first internal device is a 2-way splitter which loses 4 dB. One leg feeds directly to the VoIP modem port. This port would be connected to phone or modem services. This is a passive port, and any power loss to the amplifier would not cause interruption to these services. The second leg of the two-way is connected directly to a 15 dB gain amplifier. Each amplifier can come with either a passive or active return. There are several return gain choices. The output of the amplifier feeds the output splitter, which can either be a 4-way or an 8-way splitter. In this example, we're showing an 8-way, which loses 11 dB. We call the 8-port amplifier a 0 dB gain device, since it has 15 dB of passive loss and 15 dB of gain. The amplifier can be powered directly using the local power port or remotely through either the VoIP modem port or the RF output number 1 port. Let's take a look at the flexible powering options of the DL series amplifiers. The DL Data Plus amplifiers have very flexible powering options to meet any powering scenario. The first option is through the local power port. Local powering allows the amplifier to be powered from any convenient AC outlet by using a dedicated coaxial cable between the power supply and the amplifier just for DC power. Plug the power pack into the AC outlet and DC flows to the amplifier. The power pack and amplifier each have a green LED indicating that DC is present. There are two options for remote powering, either through the VoIP modem port or RF output number 1. When remote powering, the power inserter module is needed to be used with the power pack. Remote powering is the ability to power the amplifier from any location where there's a cable and electrical outlet close together. Typically, this can be any location where cable outlets are located, as the end consumer device needs power to work. With remote powering, DC flows on the same coaxial cable as the RF. Remote powering offers flexible powering options. Power from the VoIP or modem location through the passive VoIP modem port, or any other cable location through the RF output number 1 port. For more detailed information on remote powering, see our video, Local Remote Powering, on our website under the training category. Let's now look at the flexible mounting options. The TrueFlex tabs provide the ability to mount the DL series amplifiers either vertically, horizontally, or quick mount, providing true flexibility in mounting options. The amplifier can be mounted vertically using the included screws, or horizontally. When using an Infinity Premise enclosure with quick mount rails and the TrueFlex tabs with the quick mount groove, the DL series amplifiers can be mounted and secured without the use of screws. This provides time savings when installing and also easy access to the connectors when performing upgrades or servicing. The unique bonding block system provides a secure bonding connection without causing damage to the conductor. Let's review what we've learned in this training on the DL series Data Plus amplifiers. We showed what's included in the package, explained the model numbers, explained the features of the DL Data Plus amplifier, looked at the DC powering options, and showed the flexible mounting options. Thank you for viewing this product installation training on the DL Series Data Plus amplifiers. For additional training topics, see our website at www.amphenolbroadband.com.